No.
Sort of the European world. Melanie brought me in, giving me my exercise to say, I'm very excited to go with her to lecture on the brain.
Information is transferred in neural networks. They're also the fundamental computational unit that processes information in the brain. Synapses have been known for quite a while and have been studied a lot. But circuits have only become sort of true in the focus of attention recently.
What safe must be set aside for the research to be conducted in an ethical manner and in full respect of fundamental human life?
I believe that all the research we conduct is performed in a perfectly ethical manner. We are subject to strict regulation, which I endorse because I think we need that type of regulation, which protects the subjects, both the animal subjects and the human subjects, protects the scientists. There have been discussions, regulations that are sometimes not that easy to understand, but most of these regulations I think are both necessary and possible, and in the type of science we do, I don't think that there have been examples of unethical behavior as regards human rights or animal rights. However, that does not apply to clinical trials. That's a different issue. In clinical trials, I believe we need, if anything, even stricter rules to protect the subjects, and I think those are very important issues that are widely debated and are being addressed.
Now, there is a question from the floor from a member of parliament, Vicky Ford, who is the chair of the Committee on International Market and Consumer Protection.
I'm really sorry that another commitment can't be from listening to the main part of your lecture. But if I may be a little bit cheeky, can I ask you a question that seems to be being asked to me quite a lot in the past two or three years?